Good afternoon and welcome back to my back porch for some more straight from the garden cooking. The garden is really producing now, and we have tomatoes and eggplants and peppers and all sorts of great things coming. Today I'm going to use some of those eggplants and tomatoes to make a delicious caponata. And I'm actually going to preserve this by pressure canning it. Now there are some recipes out there that say that you can water bath process it, but I'm not really trusting that completely because the recipe has vinegar in it and it has tomatoes in it. Those both have higher acid, but it has eggplant and peppers and a lot of onions and garlic. That, my friends, is low acid. So I'm going to err on the safe side and just pop it in my pressure canner after it's all made for about 35 minutes. So let's go ahead and get started. As you can see, there are a fair number of ingredients in this recipe, but most of the work is simply done by the chopping up. And once you've got that done, then it's no big deal. So let's start off with the tomatoes. This is about 4 pounds of tomatoes. These have been washed. I'm just going to be cutting these in half and roasting them. I have some beautiful sweet peppers here from the garden and some lovely eggplants that I'm going to use. This is about 2 pounds of eggplant. I have already chopped up 2 large onions and 2 celery stalks. I'll be popping in some garlic. This is 4 cloves, but I'm going to rustle up a little bit more and put it in there. Here is about a cup and a little over a cup of chopped up Kalamata olives. What else is going to go in here? I'm going to put the remaining capers that I have. I'd like to have a few more, but I have about maybe 1/8 of a cup in there. It's going to have a little bit of salt, pepper, a little bit of sugar, and red wine vinegar. Step one of this recipe is to roast your eggplant, your tomatoes, and your peppers. Step two is to saute your onions and your garlic and your celery together. And then you throw it all together into a pot and let it cook on the stovetop for a little bit. So I have my oven preheating at 375. I'm just gonna start by slicing the tomatoes, and I'm going to put them skin side up on the baking sheet, taking the core out of these. Next, we're going to go ahead and just slice these eggplant, and I'm going to slice them in quarters and just put them skin side up on the tray. Okay. I'm using a little bit of parchment paper. I will be oiling the eggplant and just putting a little bit of a drizzle of oil over everything, just for good measure, and to give a little bit of oil in there. I don't love canning with a lot of oil, but I will do this. Now I'm gonna slice the pepper in half. I'm gonna seed it and core it. And just place it skin side up on the baking sheet. There we go. A little olive oil over these. If I had a spray mist, I would probably just spray them down a little bit. I'm just gonna go and throw these in the oven. It's at 375 and it's gonna cook for about 20 minutes, 20 to 25 minutes. During that time, I will go ahead and wash my jars and get my pressure canner heating up. All right, I have now pulled all the vegetables out of the oven. I'm going to let the eggplant cool a little bit, then I'm going to scoop out the pulp, and I am just going to lightly chop up these tomatoes. This doesn't have to be a tiny, fine job. These are going to cook additionally. Some people like to pull the peelings off. I don't mind having the peelings in there. I think it gives it a little bit more robustness. I like the fact that a lot of the nutrition is in the peeling, even though it's getting cooked out a lot. So I'm just sort of gently cutting these. Doesn't have to be done. Finally, it's just sort of being chopped a little bit. They will cook down in the next phase. I'm also going to measure out some other ingredients and combine them so that it'll make it easy to add later on. Take 1/2 cup of the vinegar, 2 tablespoons of sugar. Sugar, you say? It's going to just help bring out some of the flavor in the, it's going to help bring out some of the flavor in the tomatoes. You'll see. And I'm going to put in 1 tablespoon of salt. I'm just putting those things together so that when I'm ready to add them, it's all there and I don't have to remeasure it. Next thing I'm gonna do is saute the celery, the onions, and the garlic in, I'm actually gonna do it in water instead of in oil. Now, why am I not using oil? Well, I really don't like having oil go into my canned goods, if that's possible. I just think that it sometimes can make some problematic seals. I can use a little bit of oil, but I don't like to use a whole lot. So for this, I can, because I've already got some oil on the vegetables, I'm just going to really pre-cook the onions and the celery and the garlic. I am pouring in about a half a cup of water into a can, and into that I'm going to add the onions and the celery, and the garlic is in there too. And stir all this around, and I'm going to just let this simmer for over this heat for only about 5 or 6 minutes. Now we're going to add all the other ingredients except for the eggplant and the peppers. In go the tomatoes and olives. Here are the capers. And here's the vinegar and salt and sugar solution. Stir this all together. I'll bring it to a boil, and then we're going to turn it down to a simmer. And we're going to simmer it uncovered for about 20 minutes. All right, after about 20 minutes, I'm just now going to add in the eggplant and the peppers. And we're just going to let this cook for about another 5 minutes. Oh yeah. Now I'm going to go ahead and can mine. You can just store this in the freezer. You can eat it right away. You got options, but I want to have mine after the season is over. And this will remind me of our good summer garden. If you are canning, you want to fill it up to about within a half an inch. If you're pressure canning, it should be more like an inch. I'm pressure canning mine. I'm not going to recommend water bath canning because I'm just not sure this is high enough acid. I'm going to pressure can mine. And so here we have it. This is the caponata, and I'm going to pressure can mine for 35 minutes at 11 pounds of pressure, PSI. But you can also freeze it, and you can just gobble it up right away. And I think it would keep in the fridge for a while too. So enjoy it. I know I'm gonna. Hey, if you love to cook, if you love to garden, and your garden is pounding out produce, and you love to cook what you grow, this might be a channel for you. So do watch. Do consider subscribing and help me grow my channel. Thank you so much for watching today. Take care. Bye. All right, let's go get this pressure canner going here. Doesn't that look gorgeous?